Welcome. The Office of the Chief Data Officer and the Texas Department of Information Resources are proud to offer this course on data security. In this course, we will discuss security practices related to data. At the end of the course, you'll be able to define data security and why it is important, understand who is responsible for it, and understand aspects of data security. At the end of this course, there will be a quick knowledge check to make sure you've understood the main points of each section. What is data security? Data security is more than ensuring only authorized users can access protected information. Data security is the process and function of protecting the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of digital data, sometimes referred to as the CIA triad. It involves the planning, development, and execution of security policies and procedures to provide the proper protection of and access to data. Data security practices function in alignment with privacy and confidentiality laws and regulations, contractual agreements, and business requirements to protect an organization's assets. Data security in an organization follows these core guiding principles. Collaboration. Data security is a collaborative effort involving IT security, data stewards, data governance, internal and external auditors, and legal counsel. Enterprise approach. Data security standards and policies must be applied consistently across the entire organization. Proactive management. Success in data security depends on being proactive and dynamic, engaging all stakeholders, managing change, and overcoming organizational or cultural barriers. Clear accountability. Roles and responsibilities must be clearly defined, including the chain of custody for data across organizational departments and roles. Metadata-driven. Security classification for data elements is an essential part of data definitions. And reduce risk by reducing exposure. Minimize sensitive and confidential data proliferation, especially to non-production environments, by implementing the use of least privilege and routine data access reviews. Why is data security important? Maintaining proper data security is important because we have a legal and ethical responsibility to protect the private and sensitive information of employees, customers, business partners, and the public. Data breaches by unauthorized users or bad actors can expose confidential data, such as social security numbers or protected health information, and that exposed data can then potentially be used for illegitimate or illegal purposes. Data security is necessary for legal and regulatory compliance, for reducing the risk of financial losses and reputational damage, and for retaining the public's trust. Disruption due to ransomware attacks and data breaches can also impact an organization's ability to provide necessary services. A 2022 FBI report stated, "Ransomware attacks against local government entities and the subsequent impacts are especially significant due to the public's dependency on critical utilities, emergency services, educational facilities, and other services overseen by local governments." Advanced technologies can provide great benefits to the public sector, but should be deployed with a commitment to accountability and risk mitigation. With the rise of emergent technologies such as artificial intelligence, machine learning, and natural language processing, more and more data is being used every day in new and innovative ways, making data security more important than ever. Ensuring that data remains secure, like other aspects of data management, requires the participation of all those who touch data. Therefore, data security should be an organization-wide effort. Information security professionals are often tasked with managing IT compliance requirements, policies, practices, data classifications, and access authorization rules across the organization. Business and program leadership should partner with the organization's information security office to find solutions to data security needs to ensure a consistent enterprise-wide approach. And data management officers should work with their information security office to ensure alignment between organizational data protection strategies and the organization's approach to data management. An operational data security strategy that is properly executed, systems-oriented, and consistent across the organization can reduce costs and the risk of a security breach due to inconsistent protection practices. Data breaches and unauthorized access aren't limited to cybercriminal activities by bad actors, however. All employees of state agencies and institutions of higher education must be diligent to minimize or eliminate their own risky behaviors that might compromise data security, such as unauthorized usage of personal cloud storage, responding to or acting upon suspicious emails, emailing information between work and a personal address, and storing paper files on a physical desktop. Regular employee training and awareness programs are a critical aspect of data security and will help data users be mindful of the impact of their behaviors. What does data security entail? Overall requirements for data security come from stakeholders, government regulations, business concerns, legitimate access needs, and contractual obligations. But in general, there are three aspects to data security: classifying data, controlling access to data, and auditing data. Let's talk about each of these aspects. Data security begins by inventorying and classifying an organization's data to determine the applicable security controls and protections for the data. The overall process includes the following general steps: identify and classify sensitive data assets, locate sensitive data and information systems throughout the organization, determine how each asset needs to be protected, identify how this information interacts with business processes, and apply appropriate security controls and routinely monitor the protections to ensure they are compliant. In Texas, data classification follows standards that have been set by the legislature and managed through the Texas Administrative Code. Specific data classification terms can look unique to each organization, but generally, organizations will categorize data into four types: public, sensitive, confidential, and regulated. Public data is information that can freely and without reservation be made available to the public. Data with a public classification typically poses little to no risk if disclosed, since public data is freely accessible by anyone. Some examples of public data include agency publications, press releases, or public web postings. Sensitive data is information that could be subject to release under the Public Information Act, but should be controlled to protect third parties. This is data that isn't meant for public exposure, and while there may be some level of harm if exposed, the potential harm is relatively minimal. Examples may include an organization's budgetary plan or data in transit before it has been published for public use. Confidential data is information that is typically accepted from the Public Information Act. If this data is exposed, the organization responsible can face negative ramifications, including penalties or fines. Some examples of confidential data include attorney-client communications, computer vulnerability reports, and protected personnel information. A comprehensive list and description of the exceptions to disclosure can be found in the Texas Government Code, Chapter 552, Subchapter C. Regulated data is information that is subject to specific laws and regulations by a state or federal regulation or other third-party agreement governing its collection, storage, use, and disposal. This is data mandated by statute or regulation that must be protected from unauthorized access or disclosure. If this data is exposed, the organization responsible for the data could face negative consequences, including penalties or fines. Some examples of regulated data include data that meets the definition of personally identifiable information and sensitive personal information, protected health information, and federal tax information. In some organizations, confidential and regulated data may be treated the same and combined into a single data classification. An organization may also define additional data classifications to meet business needs. To assist organizations in their data classification efforts, the Texas Department of Information Resources provides a classification guide and a template on the DIR website. Once data is classified, access to it can be properly controlled. Data access control is a process of determining who is allowed access to certain organizational data and under what circumstances that access is allowed. Using techniques such as authorization and authentication, data access controls make sure the appropriate people can access the data they need and prevent unauthorized users from gaining access to sensitive, confidential, or regulated data. All data users in Texas state agencies and institutions of higher education are responsible for protecting data from unauthorized access, no matter what their role is within the organization. The Texas Administrative Code, Chapter 202, or TAC 202, includes information security standards, including incident reporting requirements. In the event that unauthorized access to data occurs, any state employee discovering the incident has a responsibility to report the incident promptly to their immediate supervisor and to their agency's information security officer or similar role. The organization must also report certain confirmed or suspected security incidents to the Texas Department of Information Resources if the incident meets criteria specified under TAC 202. Note that it may not be possible to gather all relevant information immediately, in which case it is generally advisable to submit an initial report as soon as possible and update the report as new information is collected. Organizations that have inventoried, curated, and classified their data assets are more effective in meeting the reporting requirements outlined in TAC 202, such as assessing the significance of the breach and any potential losses. For more information, guidance on incident reporting can be found on the Department of Information Resources website. Consult with your agency's Information Security Office or other appropriate office if you have any questions about these reporting requirements or the process for reporting security incidents in your organization. The third aspect of data security is auditing data. Regular data security audits ensure the organization is properly protecting its data, complying with laws and regulations, and avoiding liability and fines. Audits typically test against internal and external criteria regulating data security. Internal criteria are defined by the organization's own IT policies and procedures, and external criteria include things like federal, state, and local laws and regulations. By comparing actual practices with relevant standards, data security audits can identify security strengths and weaknesses and aid in the development of risk assessment plans and mitigation strategies. Finally, audit trails provide for accountability of modifications to information resources and for all changes to automated security and access rules, as well as for violation attempts. You have now completed the Texas Data Literacy Program course on data security. During this course, we have defined data security and why it is important, discussed who is responsible for it, and discussed the different aspects of data security. For more information on data and information security, visit the Office of the Chief Information Security Officer website. For more information on data governance and data management principles, visit the Office of the Chief Data Officer website.